Hey, welcome to Worship Artistry. I'm Jason.
Sup?
This is Nick.
Me. I am me.
Yeah, that's right. It's Nick, and we're in a fight.
I don't even want to talk about it anymore. We've been talking about it for 2 days, it seems.
We're going to treat this camera like it's our therapist and work through our process.
Help. Just tell him he's wrong.
It's every time you look at me, it just upsets me.
I look through you.
I can tell.
Gosh, whatever.
It's so dark back there. Anyway.
I think that it's more important to worry about your tone.
And I think it's more important to just keep learning and moving stuff. What's happening here is we were talking about teaching and learning.
Yep.
And, you know, I mean, I've taught guitar for 20 years.
I've never taught it.
I mean, whatever. So you can decide.
I'm probably better at it.
Possibly. Depends on what we're playing.
Not the guitar, teaching.
Oh, even.
I've never taught, so I'm probably better.
Probably.
So listen to me.
That's right. He's a disruptor.
I got this dent on my neck.
But here's the.
Okay. Good one.
But here's the question, okay? When you're learning an instrument, and specifically the guitar.
Yeah.
I think the question that we got into is, like, what is the order of operations?
Sure. Yep.
What matters the most?
Yeah.
Because I've always been of the mind that, like, you need an instrument that's just the easiest thing you can possibly get to play, but for like as little money, because who knows if you're going to stick with it.
Right.
And then it's just to keep moving. Like, I don't really care when I had private students, I wouldn't care if they came in and just kind of halfway flubbed their way through something. Mm. And then I want to do something else. And I just be like, okay, well, let's go on to another song.
Sure.
With my idea that the more experience they get, the more they'll just naturally start moving towards sounding better.
Yeah, sure.
But you said that was like the exact opposite for you.
Yeah, for me. Because when I first got started, I did the same thing, right? Mm-hmm. I got a very cheap guitar, very cheap amp. My parents bought it at a young age, and he may not like it, yada, yada. I get all that and definitely do that for the beginner, for sure. But again, I didn't have lessons, so I didn't really have anybody to tell me what to do. But what I knew was I was better than a lot of my friends at the time. And what I found out, what they didn't focus on, was like the quality of the note, the tone, the tonality of things. And so that's what I started to really focus on, because I was like, I know I could do what they're doing and it sounds better. Why?
Right, right.
And so I really focused at an early age on tone over like, all right, I'm going to learn how to shred, or I'm going to learn just a bunch of notes, or I want to learn how to play songs. Sure, I did do those things, but like, you know, I focused more on like the quality of that chord.
Sure.
Are all the notes supposed to ring out?
Right.
you know, things like that. And so
for all the worship guitarists out there, when we're talking about tone, you're actually talking about the way you play.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
It's like, I just got to get the quality of that reverb. Does it bloom?
Yeah.
What is the pre-delay?
That is something. And a lot of people seek that out for good tone. And that is not what I mean. Sure. I do mean that in the end product, because I always believe that if you put in better ingredients, you're going to have a better pizza.
100%.
Papa John's. That's a lie. Their pizza is terrible.
I was going to say, you went to Papa John's?
It's terrible. But you know what I mean? Like, you put in better ingredients, you're going to have a better product at the end.
So don't always be Papa John's is what we're saying.
I always believe
Sponsored
that.
Sponsored by Pizza Hut.
I wish.
Just kidding. Come get us.
Come get us, yeah. But for real, so like that was something that translated for me into like better sound quality at, you know, with reverb or delay and stuff, because I wasn't having these weird buzzes, or like my intonation wasn't weird because I wasn't like playing weirdly, like pushed a little bit.
Right.
I was focused on just that's the note.
That totally makes sense. And I'm totally with you on that. I think that the question for me was always, I think, just kind of that initial starting point, because I think that, once again, a lot of scars from my piano playing days.
Sorry
to all my teachers. Hmm. I probably scarred them a little bit too, if we're being fair.
We have them on line three, so we'll put them.
Oh, jeez. Hello, Miss Gabriel.
Yes, hey, Jason.
I'm sorry, that's so disappointing.
Man, this therapist says it's working great for you.
No, but like I think some of it comes from the desire for perfection right away.
Sure.
The idea that like you can't play this if you're rushing it a little bit, or you can't play this if this isn't perfect timing, because I think sometimes I think hyper focusing on some small thing actually gets you stuck on that thing.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because you're thinking about it so hard. It's like, you know, you guys, when we hit this record button, I know exactly what I'm going to talk about right beforehand.
And then
the record button, I'm like,
the old, what do they call that? I can't remember. All of a sudden, the red light syndrome.
Yeah, major red light syndrome. All of a sudden, like, what is our video about again?
I can't remember.
I don't even remember. That's why we digress so much.
That's right.
But so you can get kind of hyper focused on it. I think, like, with learning, so much of it is muscle memory and just kind of figuring things like that. Mm-hmm. But I will agree with you that tone and the way that you play and all that is very important, because somebody who, you know, like right now, my kids have just started.
Okay. Yeah.
Which is like my dream come true. Like, Dad, can you teach us guitar? Like,
that's awesome.
Yeah. For so long, they were like, Dad, you're so lame. You're so lame. Like, you want to play my nice guitars and my nice amp?
No.
Like, all right, that's fine. All right,
whatever, Dad.
But yeah, they're turning over a leaf. Yeah. Anyway, but, you know, this is what they're playing. Or they start going super.
Well, I was taking. I was like, Jason, that's really bad. Like, and then I got you were showing what they're. I was like, you should stop,
dude. Funny story.
All right.
I taught guitar privately for many years, and it was funny. I got to the point where it was hard for me to mimic what my students were doing because I couldn't play it bad.
Gotcha.
I could be like, oh, you're trying to, like, this is what you're doing. No.
Hold on.
It's hard for me to play as bad as you're playing.
I always try to,
kids love to hear that.
Tap off tempo and I always end up back on.
Oh, yeah, it's impossible. But good for us.
Good for us.
But that's what they're doing, right? Like, they're sitting there going, hey, Dad, I got it.
Yeah.
And you're like, you don't really have it, but keep working on it in time to learn something new.
Yep.
You know? And then the next one, all of a sudden, and it's a little more open. And they're like, this is easier. Mm. And then it's like, okay, now go back to the other thing and see if that's easier.
Right.
And then it gets a little, it's a little better.
Yeah.
And then that slowly builds up.
Gotcha.
But I've also had many students who come in after having played for a long time, like, I was trying to get better. You're like, cool, let me hear you play something. And it's like, they can't change in time.
Yeah.
Or their quality of their notes is horrible.
Yeah.
And that's a terrible move. So when you talk about quality of notes,
yeah,
when you're like a good sound, like, what does good tone mean? What does that mean to you?
So to me, initially, like, immediately, let me get this Lambertone's cup out of here. Man, I love having coffee with me. Need it. So let's just look at this G. And so what I always have done, and I really focused on putting my finger as close to that fret as possible, mm-hmm, versus like just I'm there. I'm in between the two frets I need to be in between.
Right. I have all the space.
Yeah.
Why am I not using it?
But like, yeah, sure, if I have a lot of gain on or if I'm really pushing down, now I can make it happen. But as a beginner, I couldn't like push hard enough way back here towards the second fret when I needed to be towards the third fret to make it sound like it was more like that. Yeah. Like versus now I can do it anywhere. That's not the point. But as beginners, we're flubbing around. We're kind of like all like, oh, yeah, I'm going to throw these chords together. Like,
right, yeah. Check it out.
Hey, just played, Stranglehold. Oh, yeah, I think I could hear that.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, totally. Yeah. Oh, I see what you're trying to do there.
Yeah, okay, cool. But so instead of like, just spirit struck, right?
Yeah, that's, I got it.
Spirit, right?
Yeah, that's totally, 100%. Right? That's the song.
Yeah. Back in white, race to life, 3 days later. Sorry, that's...
Are you just making that up right now?
Anyway, back to life, 3 days later.
So good, so cool.
But yeah, so with I didn't really worry about like changing the chords too much at first.
Right.
I mean, I did, but then I started like, how do I get better? Because I can do everything my friends are doing, and I hear that sounds bad. And I wouldn't tell them that, of course, but like,
yes, you
I
would.
Did, yeah, I probably did, but I didn't like it. So I was like, I want to learn from that. And so I really just focused on getting my fingers, all of them. I can't put every single finger as close, like on that fret, you know what I mean? But I can get it as close as possible. So I worried about the quality of the notes and all of them. you know, versus like wait down here and not pushing harder. It's just, it's like you can hear it, but it's out of tune. The intonation's really, really bad, and you're like, man, this guitar sucks. No, it's probably you.
Right.
So just worry about the quality of the note versus how many notes you can play, or like, hey, just learned, you know, I don't know. But like, you're playing it like...
Right.
Got it.
You're so good at playing bad.
Yeah. I'm very good at being bad. But like, if you're there and you can't do it, that's fine. Just slow down. Worry about the notes. Like
you said the S word.
Slow down. Yeah, just slow down.
Nobody likes that word.
Nobody does.
Everyone's like, oh, I got it. You're like,
you gotta go slow.
You're
to go
playing
fast.
Faster than the song.
Yeah, right. Like, do you understand you're like almost doubling the BPM? Yeah.
Like that's not the song.
No, it's like cool. But like I hated it hearing it when I was a kid, but you have to slow down to go fast.
Yeah.
I mean, one of the first guitar solos I ever learned, truthfully, like note for note, was Today's the Day by Lincoln Brewster.
Oh, I thought when you had me, I was like, oh.
No.
Started with today. I was like, Lincoln Brewster. Oh,
no, yes. Today
Jeez,
was
way
the
to,
day.
Way to kick off with Lincoln Brewster. Well, did you learn that on Worship Artistry?
No.
Because I did teach that.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I did.
No, this wasn't. This was, I think, pre-Worship Artistry. but yeah, it was Today is the Day or whatever. And learned that. And that was like.
It's a hard solo.
Yeah, super hard. And I mean, I had soloed and all that stuff, but like note for note. And I really tried. But what I had done was, I just learned it with the track, never took the track out, or like tried to play it without, or just a metronome. And I got there on Sunday, and everybody dropped out. Here comes the solo. And I'm trying to play it like three times faster than everybody, because that's how I practiced
right,
it.
Right.
And I got so good at playing it so fast and all that stuff. But like, the thing is, I had to start so slow,
right.
Like very, very slow, because I wanted the notes to be heard, mm-hmm. not just like, you know, I'll play it poorly here, but let's throw some gain on. But like part of that solo, I think I can still remember, is the... And I can play that like... I haven't warmed up.
This guy.
You know what I mean? So it's like, it's dumb. And I was like doing stuff like that. And I was like, how cool is that, everybody? And everybody's like, we're on the second measure of that
slow. Like, I was done.
You know, so, but like, I learned to do it slow to get fast. And then for me, though, it was hard to then bring it back because I didn't practice well.
Yeah.
So that's the thing, too, is like, worry about the tone, the quality of note, and practice well. What does practice well mean, Jason? Thank you for asking. it's literally like, learn the song if you want to learn a song, but try if you've learned that solo or something note for note, like maybe Loop Community or something, like you're practicing with that. You can solo things, you can mute things, right? Try to take that out and you do it alone and find out how poor you play it first.
Yeah,
because it's like the idea of like singing along to a song in a car, like, man,
I sound incredible.
Once that music stops. You are no longer Adele. You know, yeah, it's pretty bad. But it's a similar idea. Once everything kind of drops, do you have the confidence?
Yeah.
And I think that by building quality, worrying about your intonation a lot, that really gives you the confidence that you need to then nail it live. Because for me, man... Once I started worrying about the tone and the quality of things, things got so much easier for me, because before that, I remember the first time I ever played live, I had a little PV Raptor Stratocaster kind of guitar and a PV Rage 158. And I had a
PV Rage.
Dude, sick.
That drive channel was awesome.
Oh, I didn't use the drive channel. I used clean, and then I ran a Digitech RP80 into it.
Ooh, you had a pedal?
Yeah.
I eventually got a DOD grunge.
Oh, that would have been way cool. This is a multi-effects, just terrible thing. Wow. But it had a nice little, like a volume pedal. I used it as a wah pedal.
Yeah.
And, well, anyway, I kicked on the overdrive, and when I did that, my whole body started violently shaking. Because I was, like, so nervous, and I was like, because I'd only ever been, like...
Yeah.
You know, then all of a sudden, I was, like, playing power chords, like... You know, I was like... I kicked it and I was like, and I couldn't play the notes, and the singer looked at me and she was like, and I was like, I did a thumbs up. Like, I didn't know what to do. And so I was like, man, I got to do something different. I got to change my life.
Everything's going sideways.
Yeah, so I just started worrying about tone and the quality of it. And because I knew I sounded good,
right,
I was like, I can do this, right. You know? And then I started finding out, like, oh, I can't play Stevie Ray Vaughan because I'm trying to play Stevie Ray Vaughan through, like, a, well, terrible amps, but, like, this Rage 158 with, like, this terrible, totally different pickup scenario than right. what Stevie Ray Vaughan was doing. So I learned that, like, if I want that sound, I need that guitar with, like, similar pickups.
Right.
You know, it's not every guitar can do every sound like right. I used to think. So you learn those things because initially every amp sounded the same, every guitar sounded the same.
Right.
And I was like, why are there so many? You know?
Because Brian does IRs of all of them. That's why.
Yes. Worship tutorials.
Check out worship tutorials.
That's so funny. But yeah, so I don't know. I just really worried about quality of note, the tone, and the speed came, and then it was really easy from there.
Yeah. And the thing is, what I would add to that is, because I always say, you know, like, if you're not playing in time, you're not playing music.
Gotcha.
Right? Yeah. And so there's a lot of times guys get to where, like, oh, look at how it sounds, and I got my drives and everything on it.
Yeah.
But they don't move their whole body in rhythm. And but that's one thing that I run into with beginners is everything is jumpy.
Gotcha.
You watch them and it's...
It looks fast.
Yeah, it looks like,
sporadic.
And if you actually watch, like, good players, they are so relaxed.
Smooth and slow, it looks. Yeah.
It's, you know, and it's, there's little tricks and, you know, it's like, oh, aim to land the chord at the end, you know, on the first beat. Like, land there, don't start there, you know.
Correct, yeah.
But so much of it is, like, your hands should always be moving at an even pace. It's not just your fingers moving in rhythm, your body's moving in rhythm. Everything is happening. Mm-hmm. And so the way that you're able to develop that is by slowing down,
yep,
making sure those notes sound good,
yep.
And then you start speeding up. And I'm a football fan.
Oh.
One thing, like, they talk about, American football.
Are you fan. The 12th man?
I am the 12th man.
What?
Yeah. I have a jersey.
Can I get an autograph?
Everybody
flies your flag around here.
There is one worship artistry lesson that I'm wearing my Seahawks jersey.
Oh, really?
Because they had won the Super Bowl, that one.
That's a long time ago.
Yeah, and we've been doing this for a while. But I don't even remember what song it is. I just remember one guy was like, love the website, hate the jersey.
Appreciate your ministry,
so
brother.
He's from Denver, so, you know.
Of course, yeah.
But the, I don't know where, oh, I like football.
Yeah, you do.
And what they often talk about is, like, players will, like, the game slows down for them.
Mm, yeah.
Because they're just, oh, okay, this thing that was really overwhelming is no longer scary.
Yeah.
And that's what we want to feel. And if you practice with a metronome, you'll actually get to the point where you feel like you're going incredibly slow.
Yep.
But you're actually going faster than the song.
Yeah.
And you just kind of, like, naturally, you don't get there from being like,
right.
Like, you just, I just got so good at this tempo.
Yep.
Everything sounded perfect.
It was easy. So
right. And so now I went a little faster.
Up, yeah. And it still sounded great.
Right. And you can just keep going.
Yeah.
And that's kind of how you develop that. Bad. So if you get that great tone and you get great timing,
yeah,
everything you play will sound amazing.
So I did kind of hyper-focus on the quality and tone of things. And for a long time, even worship leaders that I played with, they were always joking, like, why did you sound bad? You care about tone so much. I was like, why? Why are you trying to hurt me?
Yeah, why are you so mean?
Are you trying to kill me? Recently, I've focused more on, like, I guess, like, having fun, just learning some scales and learning, like, some beginner things.
Yeah.
Because I didn't. I know all of them. But I now understand what I'm doing.
Right.
And the tone's there. The quality's there. And it's getting better. I wish I wouldn't have taken 7 years off. I really wish I wouldn't have.
That's on you.
But honestly, I don't know if I would even be... I was pretty good then just because I played every single day, all the time, anywhere, every day. But I didn't really learn. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Now I'm learning and I love it because I can talk with you. And literally, like, we just did a video not too long ago about triads and the 1, 3, and 5. Probably a year ago, if you would have told me to, like, hey, our triad is a 1, 3, and 5, I would have been like, cool, dude. I'm going to go play an E minor pentatonic. Don't tell me what to do. quit cussing at me. What is a 1-3-5, you know? And so, but I understand that now. Mm-hmm. It's the 1, 3, and 5th note in the scale. And the major scale is what we're talking about. And so that's so interesting to me that we can have these conversations. And much like you were saying, when like you're just playing, you think you're playing so fast, so good, and out of time, it sounds like gibberish.
Yeah.
You know, we're talking. Like, music is a language. I really feel that. 'Cause like when we start jamming, dude, like we just naturally just start like swaying and moving to it. Like,
100%.
Yeah. When it's good, right? So it's like, but when it's not, you're just like,
really?
Rock.
You'll find it.
Yeah, you'll get there probably.
You'll find it.
That was so much fun. But I don't know. So I think it's definitely both and. Yeah. You know, I'm done being mad at you. I'm sorry
It's all right.
20 years now.
Wow, that's.
I know. I didn't even know you back then, but I was upset.
Yeah.
I was like, there's somebody in my life I don't like right now. Jason House.
And we just fixed it.
We fixed
just
it.
Just like that.
Praise.
I'm not mad at you anymore either.
Yeah. Well, good. Because
turns out we were both right.
We were both right.
And the journey was the destination.
The destination wasn't the journey.
What are you talking about?
On that note, we'll see you guys later. Make sure to subscribe and be notified if you want to ring the bell to get notified. Please do it. We just hit 80,000 subscribers. We're stoked about
that. Dude, I know.
That's so cool when you text me that.
I know. When we get to 100,000, we're giving away a little alligator
pedal. The old Morley. Yeah. That's awesome.
Super cool.
So tell your friends about us. You might win a Morley little alligator pedal. It's really good.
It is great.
It works.
Yeah, that's right.
It doesn't look like it works. All right. See ya.